Number 8, Egal Seisman. During their honeymoon cruise in July of 2018, Israeli couple Egal Seisman and Shir Frankel opted for an excursion to the Honduran island of Roatan, which also included a zipline tour. The newlyweds, both in their 20s, were passengers on the Allure of the Sea ship, operated by Royal Caribbean Cruises. On the third and longest line of the course, Frankel went first, in the seated position. Unbeknownst to those still on the platform, she'd come to a halt and started going backwards. Seisman was up next, on the same line. The guide sent him down in the plank position, in opposition to what the safety briefing had recommended. With Frankel out of view, Seisman crashed headfirst into her at high speed, sustaining fatal injuries. Frankel was taken for surgery to Israel, with multiple traverse fractures, broken ribs, and a bruised spleen. She subsequently sued Royal Caribbean for $1 million, claiming she and her husband had been misled to believe the zipline tour had been organized by the cruise company when it was actually run by an independent contractor. Number 7. Tom and Eileen Lonergan. On January the 25th of 1998, an American couple became lost at sea off the coast of Australia after they were unintentionally abandoned during a scuba diving excursion. The last time Tom and Eileen Lonergan were ever seen was by other divers in their group, underwater, exploring the Great Barrier Reef. The passengers and crew on the MV Outer Edge didn't notice that the couple was missing. Their disappearance became evident 2 days later, after a bag of their personal belongings was found aboard the vessel. A massive search ensued, but yielded no results. In the following months, pieces of their equipment were found washed ashore, about 75 miles from where they were lost. These included a fin, compressed air tanks, and life vests marked with their names, as well as a diver's slate dated January 26. It read, "We have been abandoned on Agincourt Reef by MV Outer Edge, 25th January 1998, 3 p.m. Please help to rescue us before we die." Excerpts from Tom's journal later leaked to the press detailed that he was looking for a quick and peaceful death. Eileen had expressed concerns about him in her own journal, but was determined to stand by his side until the end. A theory emerged that the Lonergans had staged their disappearance or committed suicide together, but it was promptly shut down by their families, a coroner, and the police, who noted the fragments had been taken out of context. Even though they'd been abandoned in shark-infested waters, experts speculated they weren't attacked. They likely experienced delirium from dehydration, voluntarily removed their equipment, and then drowned. The vessel's captain was charged with their unlawful killing, but was later found not guilty. The company he ran, Outer Edge Dive, admitted negligence and was fined out of business. Number 6. Meikul Corocio Acuña. In February of 2017, a Chilean tourist got lost in the Bolivian Amazon for more than a week and a half, where he survived by following a troop of monkeys. 25-year-old Meikul Corocio Acuña was camping with Max Adventures near the Tuiki River in Madidi National Park. The area was only accessible by boat and miles away from the nearest town. In the evening, he returned to camp from a guided excursion, while the other travelers took part in a ceremony to thank Pachamama, or Mother Earth, for allowing them to visit the rainforest. Acuña remained in his cabin. At one point in the evening, he disappeared without a trace. It's unclear why he'd chosen to wander off in the rainforest, as Acuña only remembered that he'd impulsively started running, throwing away his cell phone, flashlight, and sandals. He then tried to get back, but lost his way. His Bolivian guide believed that by not taking part in the gratitude ceremony, he'd angered Pachamama, who'd sent the vengeful spirit Duende to take him to another dimension. In spite of extensive search efforts, the only clue was found 6 days later, in the form of a muddied sock, which Acuña's mother confirmed had belonged to him. It was used by shamans, who performed rituals, trying to locate him in the spirit world. Meanwhile, Acuña survived in the rainforest with the aid of a monkey troop, which he said had led him to fresh water and shelter every day. He reportedly ate the fruit that they dropped from the trees. 9 days from his disappearance, park rangers heard Acuña screaming on the riverbank, less than a mile from the camp. He was weak, dehydrated, and had nearly been eaten alive by insects. He recovered and credited God with his rescue, not shamans or the spirits endemic to the local culture, in which he didn't believe. Number 5. Daniel Mee and Jaden Dolman. In July of 2019, a British tourist helplessly watched as two of his friends plummeted to their deaths in Alicante, Spain. Daniel Mee, Jaden Dolman, and Lewis Higgins had been partying for a few days following their arrival in the Mediterranean port, a coveted destination for many British holidaymakers. On the third day of their visit, the trio was walking on a beach promenade in Orihuela Costa. They'd reportedly been drinking all day and were supposed to meet with some people they chatted to on the flight from the UK. Higgins was carrying the group's possessions in his backpack because his companions had suffered sunburns to their backs. Mee and Dolman, both in their 20s, were dangerously posing near the edge of a cliff while Higgins was taking pictures. An off-duty civil guard officer had reportedly warned them to take care. Mee and Dolman were embracing as they lost their balance and went over the railing, falling 30 feet. The same officer who'd previously warned them was on the beach and watched them tumble over the edge. Mee suffered critical head injuries and was pronounced dead at the scene, while Dolman was flown to a nearby hospital where he too passed away the following day. After witnessing the accident, Higgins was so shocked and distraught that he reportedly had to be immobilized. It would later be determined that alcohol, cocaine, and hashish had been factors in the incident. Number 4. Kushila Stein. In 2019, New Zealand woman Kushila Stein was lost at sea for 2 days off the coast of Greece. 45-year-old Stein was helping a British man, named only as Mike, take a yacht from Turkey to Athens. She then decided to stretch her legs and sailed a dinghy to the island of Folegandros. She spent the day shopping on the island and then called Mike to tell him she was on her way back. However, on Stein's return to the yacht, one of her oars fell over and strong winds pushed her inflatable boat out to sea. Mike called the authorities the following morning, and a search for the woman was launched by the Coast Guard. It involved multiple vessels, a helicopter, and an underwater drone. As an experienced sailor trained in sea survival, Stein took measures to optimize her chances of being found alive. She survived without any drinking water by rationing a handful of hard candies. Stein wrapped herself in plastic bags to keep warm at night. She used mirrors and wore a red bag on her head to make herself visible to passing boats or planes. However, in case rescuers would fail to locate her in time, she wrote her mother's name and phone number on the side of the boat. Fortunately, after a 40-hour ordeal, the Coast Guard found her halfway between Folegandros and Crete, Greece's largest island. She was treated for exposure and dehydration. After her rescue, she reportedly called her mother and told her that she still had one piece of candy left. Number 3. Ashley Judd. While tracking bonobos on an excursion through the Congolese rainforest, actress Ashley Judd suffered devastating leg injuries that would require her to be transported across the border into South Africa. Judd was experiencing trouble with her headlamp when she tripped over a fallen tree. Her leg was shattered in 4 places, and she also suffered nerve damage. The pain caused Judd to go into shock and pass out. It took several hours for the 52-year-old actress to be transported out of the rainforest by porters, carrying her on a hammock. While still in excruciating pain, she was then transported to different locations via motorcycle for another 6 hours. Hospitals in the Democratic Republic of the Congo were ill-equipped to deal with the extent of her injuries. Judd thus had to be driven for 55 hours to a hospital in South Africa, where she was admitted to a trauma unit. Talking to a journalist on Instagram Live, she expressed gratitude, while also commenting on the privilege of being able to rapidly receive help, as opposed to a Congolese person who might not have had such swift access to medical treatment. Today's topic was requested by Horde, not Nathan. If you have any other topics you'd like to learn about, subscribe and let us know in the comments section below. Number 2. Hiker killed in Mount Stromboli eruption. In early July of 2019, Mount Stromboli, on the eponymous island off the coast of Sicily, experienced 2 explosive events. The twin eruptions, which took place at 2:46 p.m., were described as among the strongest to have ever occurred on the island. As the ash plume rose high into the sky, lava spewed from all active mouths of the volcano. A local priest described it was like being in hell, as native villagers and visiting tourists were forced to flee from a rain of fire. Amid the terror of the blast, dozens of tourists threw themselves in the sea to escape the volcanic flow. Luckily, they were promptly evacuated. A 35-year-old man whose identity wasn't released was near the summit when the eruption occurred. The hiker, originally from Sicily, was fatally struck by falling debris. His Brazilian companion was rescued in a state of dehydration and shock. Six other people sustained minor injuries in the disaster's wake. Number 1. Sam Beatty. In December of 2016, during a gap year, New York man Sam Beatty and his girlfriend, Michelle Sigala, went on holiday to Australia. 8 weeks into their trip, which saw them travel around the country in a van, the couple was on an excursion to Mount Warning in New South Wales. They camped out at the top. Shortly before 4 a.m., lightning struck their tent and then jumped to Beatty's feet, killing him instantly. Sigala, who suffered head and neck injuries, spent several hours crying next to his lifeless body while waiting for help. Two teenage hikers heard her. One went to find rescuers while the other stayed with her and performed CPR on Beatty, but to no avail. Sigala was taken to hospital in a state of shock, where doctors would later tell her she was lucky to have survived. Thanks for watching. What's the one place you'd never want to visit, even if all your expenses were paid? Let us know in the comments section below.